Children's animated films are not scientifically accurate documentaries. But what if they were? Let's start with Finding Nemo. In reality, clownfish are what's called sequential hermaphrodites. That means when the dominant female of a group dies, the largest male, like Marlin, would become female, leaving Nemo as the new male. That's a considerably different story. Also, Dory's species, the blue tang, can't breed in captivity at all, contrary to her aquarium birth story in Finding Dory. In reality, her family would have been kidnapped from the wild and sold into a glass-walled circus. Now, Pixar actually consulted scientists for Nemo to get many other facts right, but I can see why they left those out. Next, The Lion King. Big yikes here. Okay, in real lion prides, when a male takes over a pride from another male, they often commit infanticide, killing all the existing cubs so that they can mate with all the females and pass on their own genes. So, after Scar's takeover, he would have killed Simba himself, not just banished him or left him to the hyena assassins. And when he was done, he would have killed Nala and the rest of the cubs too. And since males like Mufasa would mate with all the females in their pride, the movie also ignores that Simba and Nala would more likely be half-siblings, which is weird, but now that I think about it, also not terribly inaccurate given some actual historic royal families. This next example is, by far, I think, the most likely to ruin your childhood. The Little Mermaid. Listen, if merfolk were biologically plausible, a half-human, half-fish would need either gills or a blowhole, because human-type lungs just can't handle the pressure of long, deep dives, okay? And to combat drag, her dainty little arms would be flippers instead. Finally, living in cold ocean depths means Ariel would have thick blubber or fur to stay warm. All in all, a scientifically accurate mermaid might look more like a furry, flipper-armed sea creature than a princess. The hairy mermaid, maybe? You remember in Aladdin when they fly from Egypt to Athens, Greece in literally 1 second? We know that because they don't skip a beat in the song, okay? Well, that means they were flying at roughly 700 miles per second, which is over 2 million miles per hour, which is plenty fast enough that Jasmine, Aladdin, and that little carpet would have been incinerated by air resistance. And it's not just Disney. The Bee Movie? Well, in real honeybee hives, all worker bees are female. Males only attend to the queen and provide sperm for mating. The bros don't even have stingers. And in real life, starfish eat sponges, which means Patrick would have killed and devoured his best friend a long time ago. And out there in the wild, foxes eat hedgehogs, which means Tails would have eaten Sonic if he could catch him. Listen, it's always nice when movies get the science right, but it's also nice when science doesn't ruin your childhood and make you need years of therapy too. Any more favorite cartoon scientific inaccuracies? Leave a comment and follow me for more cool science stories.